Hi everyone, I am back with a new market update. I hope everyone had a fabulous 4th of July long weekend. I was fortunate enough to spend time, much needed break, with family and friends in the Northern Neck, and we had like beautiful weather finally for once because it was so crappy over Memorial Day. So it's nice to be outside and all that good stuff. But anyways, I wanted to give you sort of a quick update. Like, nothing has drastically changed since the last time, but we had sort of like a recent call, you know, with Dr. Lawrence Yoon, who is the chief economist for the National Association of Realtors. And they do a profile every year, and he gave some updates on what we're seeing, just, and it's more on a national level. You know, real estate is local, but anyways, so they are projecting the highest number of transactions this year since 2006, over 6 million transactions, real estate transactions are going to occur in the US in 2021. Forbearance is currently being phased out. A lot of people were thinking, oh gosh, after that, we're gonna have foreclosures, but that's not the case. Some people will need to sell their houses, but will not be in a foreclosure situation due to the high home prices. So they have enough equity that they are just selling their home, so it's not gonna go into foreclosure. Again, Google most asked question is, this a bubble? And it was up 2,450% from the last time I talked about this. And the answer is no. We have about 1.2 million homes for sale. The last time this occurred, which I was licensed and working and I lived through this, we had four times as many homes for sale. So that's a huge difference. Plus, we don't have all the shady town mortgages and things like that. People aren't getting the ARMs, and they're not getting their adjustable rate mortgages, and they're not getting the balloon payments. People are pretty much going with your standard 30-year fixed. The typical down payment on average is now 15.9%, which back then people were getting those 0% down, where they're getting an 80-10-10 or an 80-20. So on average, people are putting 15.9% down, which is really high. The lowest you can do is 3.5%, unless you are military and you can get a VA loan where you can put 0% down. So even if prices decline, we still have an army of buyers out there who have been outbid trying to get in the market. I mean, I have highly qualified buyer clients who make a lot of money and have huge down payments and can waive like appraisal, and they still are getting outbid. So the quality of the buyers is really great, and they still are trying to get into properties. So if the prices do go down, it's just gonna be a second chance opportunity for all these buyers that haven't been able to secure anything yet. And seeing that rental prices are going up, interest rates will have slight adjustments, third and fourth quarter, new construction should become available. So the lumber prices have gone down, so it looks like the builders are starting to apply for permits and zoning, and they're gonna start building more. That was part of the problem, is there's just not new construction homes for people to buy, and so they're only have the opportunity to buy resale, which has caused some of the lack of inventory. So a lot of elderly were concerned with selling their homes during COVID. Now that they're vaccinated, they're more likely to also start listing their homes. So that's a whole nother market of people who want to downsize or move out of the area, or they need one floor living, or they need maybe not assisted living, but they need something like a community where there's help. So we're hoping that some of those homes come in the market. The top Google searches are still, when is the housing market going to crash? Why is the market so hot? And how much over asking price should I offer? Same answers as I gave in the last video. But so I'm just going to kind of sum up what buyers should expect. Buyers should expect the process on average to take about 96 days. And 96 days would be the amount of time to actually get one of your contracts to actually go through. And then, you know, usually closing is 30 to 45 days. And if the seller needs a rent back, sometimes you're giving them a 30 to 60 day rent back. So the longest period you can have is a 60 day closing with a 60 day rent back. So actual closing period, once you've identified and secured a property, the longest it can be is 120 days. But that's, you know, added on to the fact that, you know, it could take you a month or two to get a home that you have an offer accepted on. So that's that. And the average buyer right now is seeing about 14 homes before they secure either like or secure a home. I mean, I have clients who, you know, they're want a home and they've gotten out, but they're not willing just to buy anything. Like previously, the last time people would buy anything, my clients are like, yeah, I don't like the way the yard is. I don't like the way the basement is. They're being a little more particular because if they're going to be paying these escalated prices, you know, they want to be happy, or they want the ability, like even if the house isn't like move in ready or whatever, they want the good bones so they can turn it into an amazing property that they can make money on in the long run. So buyers are, you know, still giving concessions. They're paying about $9,000 more in down payment than they were a year ago. 34.4% of buyers are paying over ask price, which is up 13% from last year. And they're waiving contingencies for inspections, finance. I've had, you know, septic inspections waived, which that gets a little hairy. At least with a you know, you can do what's called a walk and talk, where the home inspector will come with you on the showing and they'll just kind of quickly look at everything and be like, okay, this looks good. They'll look at the structural real quick. They just won't run every sink or faucet or, you know, all the basic stuff you can do. But you can't really do that with a septic inspection. They can't, because they got to dig up the boxes and that kind of thing. So that is a little more complicated. So it is what it is. So anyways, let's see what else. So what sellers should expect. They should expect an average on 5 offers on your house. And that's if your house is like turnkey, move-in ready, you know, location is key. Around here, it's schools. The further out you go, when you get towards Leesburg, it's a little different. But here in, you know, when I'm making these comments, I'm talking like Fairfax County, Arlington, the closer in suburbs, which is mainly where I live and work. So 42% of sellers are selling above their ask price, but I am seeing price reductions. So if you're a little crazy with your pricing, people are gonna not do it. It's better to price it at market or a little bit higher than the last one. Like I've always said, have people fighting over the price they're gonna pay than you fighting to get what you want because you've, you know, overpriced your house. House prices increased by 11.3% in 2021 and equity increased by 16.2%. So those are the main points for this market update. So if you have any questions, as usual, call, text, email, comment below. I'm happy to answer anything. If you want a home valuation, even if you're not planning on moving, I am happy to do that for you. I do every year for my clients, on their anniversary of their purchase, I ask them if they want a personal equity assessment report, which basically goes through and says, okay, this is what your house would sell for. They tell me what their mortgage balance is. And then I'll say, this is the amount of equity you currently have in your home. Even if you haven't bought with me, I'm happy to do one of those for you. You just have to let me know and let me know what your mortgage balance is. So anyways, thanks for watching and have a great rest of your week.